Good evening.
Is the sound rolling? Hopefully not. Good evening. This is triple reporting from Heathcote. The biggest thing that I remember was the shaking. I woke up and there was incredible shaking, noise, that sort of noise, and the bed just being shaken around. And I put my arm around Rachel and said, it's just an earthquake. It was so forceful. What was amazing was that not that it was an earthquake, it was just that you were bouncing around, literally bouncing on the bed. And it's everything was black, everything was dark. It was like being on a trampoline. And there was just the noise of things breaking. And I thought, God, you know, windows are going. The doors, where they don't fit properly, were just banging, bang, 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 bang. The jib board made this bass sound, so it was incredible, just racket. You've just woken up and you just don't know what's going on.
It sounded like the train, which there's a train that often comes in the night not too far away from here, but this was louder and it felt like it was coming right through the middle of the house. So it got louder and louder, and then suddenly I realised that we were moving. But it wasn't an up and down sort of movement, it was more like a violent swaying backwards and forwards. So it was very violently going backwards and forwards, and then as you registered that, you could hear all the other noises in the house as things started to fall down.
Then it stopped, and there was incredible swaying. We had no power, phone was off.
Then we started to move off the bed and quickly into the living room. It was very dark. I remember it being eerily dark for that time of the morning. Charles found the torches, so we had torches and I had my cell phone, and he also found a radio with batteries.
Got a torch, and then we came through and there were things on the floor, things had fallen over.
The shock came in later, and I think we both experienced our bodies getting very cold. And probably half an hour later, as I'd put three pairs of socks on, had a duvet wrapped around me, and I still felt cold.
I noticed my body temperature started to drop, and then I started to sort of get tight, and it's just fear kicking in afterwards. If your brain starts thinking about it afterwards, you think, where could I go? What could I do? Well, you can't go anywhere. And it's the feeling of you just totally having this thing done to you that you can't get out of it. You don't know where to go or what to do. To the point where I started to just had to breathe deeply and think, well, it's just an earthquake. Yeah, Charles, you just have to go with it.
There seemed to be a long, long waiting time and in a sort of stunned silence, listening to the radio and sitting on the couch and just feeling very cold and waiting for daylight, really. But as soon as it got light, I went to the end of our drive and met two of our neighbours and then went to check on our 80-year-old neighbour and stayed about half an hour clearing up glass and just talking to him. Then there was all the aftershocks, so after a while you started to get a little bit on edge, because the first one actually was less scary because you weren't expecting it and you were just in it and you sort of dealt with it. But then the next time it happened, and the next time your body was getting ready to, it sort of reacted more. And days later, people I met, they talked a lot about the incredible tiredness, and not just from not sleeping properly, sort of like everybody's bodies were on high alert. It became quite draining after a while. And still now, we don't know when it's going to stop.
We can't do anything about this. Nobody can go along and turn off the earthquake We can't ask somebody to stop it. The same thing is going on within our bodies, is that we can't stop a fear thing happening. You can override it by being positive, but the chemicals in your body have suddenly been kicked into gear, adrenaline, whatever it is that's happening. And your body starts to sort of shake in a funny sense. You sort of feel frightened. You just feel frightened.
So there's been a lot of background flow on from not just experiencing the actual quake. Talking to friends who've lost their businesses, who can't enter their buildings in town, the stress that it's sort of beginning to show on them, and people really unsure with what's going to happen for them in the future. And as well as just people feeling sad about icons around town not looking the same at all again, or even physical landscape where places like Castle Rock has fallen to pieces. There's a lot of changes around the environment. The historic pub in Heathcote's had to be demolished, and things that people have known and take for granted are just not there anymore.